please welcome the John Flanagan Trio.
Thanks very much. Yeah, it's a real pleasure to be in this beautiful space. And we're going to start off with a song. The song's written about the country music capital of Australia. You might have heard of it. It's called Northcote, in a suburb in Melbourne. And where all the hipsters hang out, those long-haired louts. And the song's called High on High. Here it is. One, two, three, four. Ancient Greeks are playing cards down in the High Street Night Cafe. A crowd of music from the Thornbury Theatre carries me away. Where the long beard hipsters hang, happy as hippies sipping shy. I'm floating on the feeling of this place. I'm high on high. Nobody knows me, nobody knows me but this town. Jazz cats at the tram stop, there are folkies at the local. There's a busker playing Elvis, and the drunks are getting vocal. Songs are pouring out the windows, I can't come down if I try. You and I, we're poor but happy in this place. We're high on high. Nobody knows me, nobody knows me but this town. Lately I'm finding all my old dreams are shrinking down. All that I need is you, my friend. Tired this guitar, I'm sure no one had really known. But I see the world in songs, and I just gotta let them fly. So I open up the cage and watch them soaring high on high. Nobody knows me, nobody knows me but this town. Thanks very much. How about Liz Frencham over here on that bass, double bass, doing a beautiful job. Singing her heart out. So we're going to, yeah, we are touring with this album. A lot of these songs are off our album with the John Flanagan Trio album. And this next one's on that album. It's this song about, it's called Nomad. It's a song about being on the road a lot and finding that balance between, you know, being on the road playing music, and also being at home and with the ones you love, you know. So this song's about. Here it is.
One, two, three, four.
Spirits of the lyric word, paint pictures of a flying bird, soaring high for traveling alone. The railway line, the dark highway, the promise they must leave someday, apart from only the angels could have shown. And I'll admit I felt the cold, but cut my ties and leave it all behind in hopes of some romantic dream. And in my mind, before too long, I'd stumble by the tarot song, illuminated by some bright star's beam. Oh, 'cause I got the soul of a nomad, and it's telling me running free is the only way. Oh, but I got the heart of a lover, and it's drawn to you. Tells me to stay here another day. Done my best trying to explain, and only added to the pain of those that love, knows and wonder why. Turn the key and close the door, not in search of something more, just something that I never dared to try. Oh, 'cause I got the soul of a nomad, and it's telling me running free is the only way. Oh, but I got the heart of a lover, and it's drawn to you. Tells me to stay here another day. Soft goodbye, silent vow is all that I can offer now. Is that enough? I don't know anymore. Oh, 'cause I got the soul of a nomad, and it's telling me running free is the only way. Oh, but I got the heart of lover, and it's drawn to you. Tells me to stay here another day. Yes, I got the heart of a lover, and it's drawn to you. Tells me to stay here another day.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Thanks so much. So Mike did mention my Paul Kelly story. I do have a Paul Kelly story where I got to drive him from his house. This was before Uber days, I must say. People think, what, were you a taxi driver? No, that was just a one-off little occurrence. I knew a girl who worked for a little film company who was making a music video for Paul Kelly, and I just randomly got the call that one day Paul Kelly needed a ride to go and do an interview about this music video. So, my favorite thing about playing this song around different places is everywhere we go, someone's got their own Paul Kelly story about how they've met Paul Kelly. And I must have heard, I don't know, at least 50 of them now. But from the most obscure and boring, like the people who were on holiday in Europe and they met Paul Kelly's banker or something like that. I thought that was pretty cool. But and then there was a guy who was at the urinal with Paul Kelly who was really excited about that. And then there was the guy who was in the middle of the desert, I think Northern Territory, and he came upon a little song circle out by the fire, just like these fires out there. Said to the guy playing music, "Mate, you're pretty good. You should make some recordings." Yeah. And I got a few of those. Thanks, mate. It was Paul Kelly, for those who didn't get that. And then our favourite story. Well, we got a really close Paul Kelly connection, because Paul Kelly actually came up to us after one of our gigs. We signed a CD for him, and in Orange, and it was Paul Kelly, the retired psychologist from Millthorpe, from Orange, from Bathurst, I think. I'm still not sure if Paul Kelly, the songwriter, has heard this song. I have never seen him since this day. But anyway, here's my story about Paul Kelly. It's called The Last of the Cassette Men. Here it is. I pulled into St Kilda about half an hour early, but I rang that doorbell right on time. He said, "Hi, my name's Paul." But I already knew that. Headed to my wagon by the faded street signs, and I prayed she'd make the journey, that old white 89 Camry, and she didn't let me down. The day I drove Paul Kelly from St Kilda into Melbourne town, he's the last of the cassette men. The banjo about time, with his songs of the every man, the every woman and child. If there's a torch that he's passing on, every troubadour would stake a claim. He's lit a thousand fires, even more maybe, that flame. We climbed into the car seat and spied my old stereo. He said, "A cassette man, good to know there's still some of us around." "Well, not by choice," I blurted. I didn't mean to say that. I was trying to make a joke, didn't quite make it off the ground. If that's a torch that he's passing, well, it's one I'd carry proudly, and now I'll never live it down. Day I drove Paul Kelly from St Kilda into Melbourne town. He's the last of the cassette men, the slim dusty of today, with his songs of the everyman, the struggles that come his way. Torch that he's passing on, well, they might not let me stand in line. But I stole a tiny ember, and I'm still working on my little fire. We hit our stride on King's Way, chatting about bluegrass. Find that we found something that we can sink our teeth into. But he'd never heard of Nickel Creek, and I've never heard of the Stanley Brothers. Well, I've rectified that since, Paul, that I can promise you. But we're neither of us flashy, we're both modest guitarists, we've found some common ground. The day I drove Paul Kelly from St Kilda into Melbourne town, the last of the cassette men, the Bradman of the song, with his songs of the everyman, space between right and wrong. If there's a torch that he's passing on, any torch will do. Well, I pull out my old tape player, and I'll make a mixtape too. Thanks so much. How about Daniel Watkins on that mandolin over here? Warming us all up with that incendiary playing over there. Big thanks to Mike for putting this this show on, and all, I mean, so many people involved in making this happen. It's awesome. Yeah, it's amazing what he's done here. It's just such a pleasure for us to play here in this beautiful venue. Yeah. Let's hear it for Mike. Come on, yeah. I'm sure we'll get many chances to thank him across the night. So this next one, it's another one from the album. And this one, most songs take quite a while to write, you know. I write them sometimes over years, you know. You just chip away at them. This is one that that came quite quickly, because I had an experience, a unique experience of visiting a friend's church, which I don't go to church myself, so it was a very unique experience. It was a evangelical church, and it was also at a time just after I'd experienced some heartbreak, so I guess all this kind of combined into one to come out, and this song just kind of poured out quite quickly. So it's a song called Ripples. It's on the album. So the album was recorded. Liz has a beautiful studio out the back of her place in regional Victoria, a place called Trentham. Place that snows in the winter. we got in there last year and recorded. And just got together with the three of us, got together in a room with a couple of other musicians and just recorded our live sound. There were many tears and lots of tears and laughter, mostly tears. But,
after listening to tapes, you mean?
That's right. because it's a lot of, you know, a lot of pressure on everyone to record all together, but we did it, and here's one of the songs. One, two, and one, two. Followed her to church on Sunday. She was singing in the gospel band. Though I've not been touched by Jesus, I consider him a holy man. And they tell me all the breeze must pray, and all the praise is best. And I feel the Spirit moving as I watch her heaving chest. It will strike the surface for one moment, then it's out of sight. And the rest of life is ripples of a love pure and bright. And I see a real connection in the people as they pray. And my heart is open to them, so I sing in my own way. Think of all the good and bad that has been done in one man's name. Could a pure message live on in some uncorrupted chain? It will strike the surface for one moment, then it's out of sight. And the rest of life is ripples of love pure and bright. And my memory wanders backward as the pastor rambles on to a new young couple making out on the dark street corner. His feet down in the gut, passion spilling out of them. I still don't know if that was lust or wild love, the rarest gem. Followed her to church on Sunday. She was singing in the gospel band. Made sure that you couldn't see me as she sang beside her man. Wonder does a part of our love live on in her heart today? How could anybody love as strong as we did in those days? It will strike the surface for one moment, then it's out of sight, and the rest of life is ripples of love pure and bright. It will strike the surface for one moment, then it's out of sight, and the rest of life is ripples of love pure and bright, and the rest of life. Thanks very much. So what you're hearing tonight are mostly original songs. Songs of mine that we all worked together on putting the arrangements together, and that's what you hear on the album as well. So we do have a cover for you now. It's written by a great blues singer named Keb Moe. Anyone out there a fan of Keb Moe? Yeah, good. We're playing for the right people. I grew up listening to Keb Moe, among other people. My hero, since my mum attended a lot of folk festivals and I did as a kid. My heroes were those people who played around at folk festivals. So actually, Greg Champion was a big hero of mine. Probably known from the older football songs. But he had a great kind of... I'm kind of going off topic here, but he had this great kids album, Greg Champion and the Quatermains, and he was like my hero, you know, so I used to sing along to all the songs. So it was funny realizing later that all my heroes were just kind of local people that I could just go and chat to, you know. But anyway, Keb Moe was one of these heroes, and we're going to do a Keb Moe song for you now. It's called You Can Love Yourself. For anyone who likes to go and take themselves on a date from time to time, you know. Maybe a nice walk along Victor Harbour, glass of red from your local vineyard.
Ricotera,
of course. Yeah. Treat yourself to a glass of wine. Did anyone take themselves out on a date tonight to see to the barn? Yeah, good. We've got at least once. Yeah. Well, this goes out to you, ma'am. You can love yourself by bringing yourself to see the John Flanagan Trio and Axe in the Ivory. Here it is. You can love yourself.
My baby, she wrote me a letter. She didn't call me on the phone. Five little words was all she wrote. She said, see you later, I'm gone. She left no explanation about. Joke, but I can take a hint. She don't love me no more. little too late. And if nobody loves you, and you feel like dust on an empty shell, just remember, you can love yourself. And if nobody loves you, and you feel like dust on an empty shell,
How about Axe in the Ivory, that beautiful opening set, yeah, fantastic. Yeah. Oh yeah, all the way from London, flown out. That's right. It was just beautiful, really genuinely loved that set. Some beautiful music there. There was some mention of Alice and Lester. The children's books, I can't remember exactly why, but I'm going to make a little segue from there. Because this next song is kind of inspired by a children's book. Is anyone familiar with a children's book called Window? I think it was just called Window. It was a collage, yep, okay, yep, at least one. Jeannie Baker, that's right, yeah, Jeannie Baker. I had that as a kid. I was going to say I read it as a kid, but there was no words to read. Because it was just pictorial, and it featured, it's a beautiful book, it just features looking out a window of a house, and it's this beautiful countryside, and as the years go by, you see they've got a little baby, and the baby grows up, gets older, and the landscape changes to, you know, introduce more houses, you know, a house comes up, and then a road goes through the middle, and then before too long, a McDonald's is there, and you know. And then it just kind of becomes a city. And then at the end, spoiler alert, the kid, you know, grown up with his family and moves away into the country, and then you see the city in the distance. And this is inspired by that thing that happens, you know, when there's a beautiful place and, of course, everyone wants to go there, you know, and the place changes. So it's called A Place Untouched by Man. How about these, while I'm getting ready, how about these beautiful mics before us? We've got Edwina here and Josephine, a very important part of the trio, the quintet, I should say.
And then the sound guy's operating.
Yeah. Got Dave and John. Yeah. Very beautiful job on sound. If you were near, let's carve our names into a tree.
perfect world of God's almighty hand. Come on and leave your lonesome footprints in the sand, in a place untouched by man. I wanna go to a place untouched by man, to see the perfect work of God's almighty hand. I wanna leave my lonesome footprints in the sand, in a place untouched by man, in a place untouched by man.
Thank you so much. So this is a part of the night I always enjoy, is where I get to cede control of the microphone and hand it over to one of my friends, I was going to say, without even thinking about it. But because these guys do such an amazing job, they make the sound of the trio happen. I'm going to hand it over to Liz, who's going to sing one of her beautiful songs, which is on theme for the night. Let's hear it for Liz Frencham.
Thank the beautiful Ricotera for giving us this beautiful broken forklift. It's a musket and it's really lovely. It's a fortified wine, and I've been sipping it. And you'll hear I'll try to do a good job with this song so you can hear what it does for your voice. But yeah, big round of applause for Ricotera.
Oh yeah.
The jacket's coming off this one.
Enjoy responsibly.
And you might need this, hey? Will you need it?
I'll just do that.
This is a little song, and I'm hoping they might adopt as their theme song after tonight. I'm hoping some beautiful winery adopts it at some point, but because wine's one of my favourite things in the world, so I wrote a song about it. Are you guys sing along kind of? Would you sing along?
Yeah, yes.
So the chorus of this song just goes, wine, 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 nothing sweeter than wine. Do we give that a go? Wine, 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 nothing sweeter than wine.
Nothing sweeter than a broken
tortoise. And then the second line of the chorus, there's only two, goes, wine, 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 slay me blind. And you can get as bluesy and as dirty as you like on the slay me blind, okay? Ready? Wine, 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 slay me blind. Yeah, yeah, you guys got it.
Save me blind.
Hey.
Without
is a, it's a song called Honey, I'd Buy You a Home, written about a little cottage in Launceston with a friend of mine named Daniel Townsend. And we wrote about this little cottage that was run down and up for sale. I mean, well, it was a beautiful little cottage, really, and it was by the river. Who wouldn't want to buy it? But it was heritage listed, and so they couldn't knock it down, you know. Makes it challenging to buy, and then this beautiful little cottage got more and more run down, and then certain establishments went up on either side, as you will hear in the song, making it a little bit less appealing. But this is still me and my friend's musings on maybe buying that place. It goes out to anyone who may be thinking about buying a house but isn't quite there yet. It goes like this. You can sing along now that Liz has warmed up those vocal chords with that wine. The chorus goes like this. Goes, I was about to sing wine again. But,
honey,
now we've got honey. Just to lube her up. Lube her up. No, lube her. Anyway, sing it, the song. Goes, my honey, oh my honey. My honey, oh my honey. My honey, I'd buy you a home. Give it a shot with us now. My honey, oh my honey. My honey, oh my honey. My honey, I'd buy you a home. Yeah, one more time, that's it. My honey, oh my honey. My honey, oh my honey. My honey, I'd buy you a home. Is there anyone out there who's hoping to buy a house someday who isn't quite there yet? Come on, don't be ashamed, admit it, all right? Yeah, come on, yeah, all right. I feel ya. Because if you sing it extra loud, the housing fairies are listening, okay? So you know they're out there. They're listening for you specifically. So anyway, right here it goes. One, two, a one. Back soon. take a little break now. Thank you.
John Flanagan Trio. Yeah.